Hello guys, this is Nitro from the Nitro Invisi channel. Today I will show you the build I designed for the new Thief specialization, Deadeye. With the new add-on, Thief becomes a long-range attacker and I can tell you, a deadly one. So, without further ado, let's jump straight into the guide. First of all, the equipment. I've been playing full Marauder gear, Runes of Strength and Sigil of Air and Fire on my rifle. I am playing a shortbow on my offhand because I think it's the best offhand weapon, even for ranged rifle thieves. On my shortbow, I'm going for Sigil of Energy and Sigil of Bloodlust. Many of the Deadeyes I've encountered so far have been playing dagger pistol in their offhand, but it's easy to interrupt their stealth attempts by just shooting them. There are better ways to gain stealth that don't require huge amounts of initiative. As you can see here, I use a second rifle with an Air and a Bloodlust Sigil on it.
This way,
it is easier to stack your Bloodlust to 25, because you usually don't go for any stomps, but just staying a rifle to kill your targets on high range. The reason I went for Marauder stats is simple, I just don't want to die 24/7. I chose the runes of strength over the scholar runes because I'm going for a might stack build. The consumer builds I used are the superior sharpening stones and the bowls of sweet and spicy butternut squash soup. Next off, we got the traits. I have been playing Deadly Arts, Trickery and Deadeye. I'm going full standard on Deadly Arts and Trickery as you can see here. For the Deadeye line, I'm going for Iron Sight, which reduces incoming damage on your marked target by 15%. This is super useful in 1v1 situations. Because of this, I prefer it over Revealed Malice even though I'm playing a Might Stack build. Sniper's Cover is a trait that helps you stay alive a lot longer, but it also helps you to surprise your opponents when attacking, but I will talk a bit more about tips and tricks later. At the last three traits, I decided to go with Be Quick or Be Killed. Fire for effect maybe can be a good choice too, but for solo roaming, the quickness and the power and precision boosts are just essential for your burst and overall damage output. Now, let's look at the utility spells. I am running Hide in Shadows, Infiltrator Signet, Shadow Step, Roll for Initiative and one of the new skills, Shadow Melt. Concerning the heal skill, many people are playing with the withdraw heal, which gives you more heal for sure, but because the only other strong conditioning move we have is Shadow Step, that you rarely use for just clean conditions, but for repositioning and stun breaks, we have to play condition remove heal. When it comes to heal skills, I don't want to play any high risk, high reward games, so I chose Hide and Shadows over Malicious Restoration. Hide and Shadows also provides 3 seconds of stealth and it only takes a quarter of a second more time to cast than Malicious Restoration. Infiltrator's Signet is a really strong skill because it has a low cooldown of 30 seconds, breaks, stun and moves your 900 range units in the direction of your target. Shadow Step is just a great skill overall, that's why you see almost every thief use it no matter what spec he is playing. As already mentioned, you can use it to reposition yourself, break, stun and remove up to 3 conditions. Roll for Initiative is also a great spell to use when playing Deadeye. With a low cooldown of 35 seconds, you can evade, remove cripple, chill and immobilize, breaks down and gains 6 initiative points. This skill is super important to escape out of panic strikes, roots or other long immobilizers, because you don't always got your shadow step or your rifle's death retreat skill ready. This is the reason I replaced the shadow refuge you see in the montage with the roll. Shadow Melt, our elite, can charge up to 2 stacks. Each stack, when activated, recharges after 45 seconds, removes the revealed debuff and stealths you for 3 seconds. Last but not least, here are some tips and tricks for you when playing this build. To burst someone, just use Sniper's Cover and, if necessary, Infiltrator Signet to get in range, mark your target and start firing using double tap. When using Sniper's Cover, you can still use your Infiltrator Signet to get a range of your target. You can also use your Shadow Step, of course. These spells will not be visible to enemy players, you should use that to your advantage. However, Shortbow's Infiltrator's Arrow is visible even if you are stealthed. The Infiltrator Signet can also be used to jump to nearby moas or other mobs to escape. If you have two snipers cover stacks available, you can use the first one to gain 3 seconds of stealth, immediately stand up again, walk a few steps and use the skill again before becoming visible. This way, you can juke your opponent by letting them think they know where you are kneeling. The short stealth gained by double tapping sniper's cover can also be used when escaping. When dodging from your kneeling state, press the stand up skill and dodge directly after. This way, the long animation will be cancelled and you are free to move after the dodge roll is finished. If possible, use your mark when being stealthed so the enemy can't see the animation and dodge or interrupt you. Use your mark on downed enemies as well. It will reset if they die. The quickness you gain from this is really useful to burst them or the players trying to revive them. Most of the time, your life depends on your utility skills, so don't use multiple of them at once because usually one is enough to gain enough space to start shooting again. Remember that sniper's cover also grants stealth for 3 seconds. And finally, don't forget to turn your mini off because it will reveal your position. Well, this is all I can tell you about this build right now. If I discover any new tricks or better traits, I will definitely let you know on this channel. If you enjoyed this guide, please use the next 5 seconds to like and subscribe. It really helps to grow the channel. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section or message me in-game. Have a great day, see you all soon.